In this movie, I'm going to be really concentrating on the graph area and the graph settings in the width gradient tool, part of the WidthScribe toolset. In this demonstration, I will be basing this on a radial mode and an absolute adjustment so that I can quickly reapply gradients. Let's first select these 8 straight line segments, and these have all been radially copied around this center point. And I'm going to look at this graph, which is the default graph, which is just a simple inclination from the start to the end point. And I'm going to change, for clarity's sake, from 1 point up until 10 points, like so. And I'm going to click from the middle and drag out to the extreme, like so. Now, one thing I may want to do straight away is actually invert that change. I may actually want to go from 10 points to 1 point. Now, there are two ways of doing this, quite simply. I can either click on this vertical up-down arrow button to swap the values, like so, and then I'm going to reapply this gradient. Or, if I swap it back, I could equally take this graph handle and take this one up to the 10 point, which is the starting value, and take the end value down to 1 point. And if I clicked on reapply gradient, you should see exactly the same effect again. There should be no change to the artwork. So there are two ways of actually altering the way it goes round from start to end. Okay, what else can we do with this graph? Well, I can drag actually these points anywhere I wish. So if I dragged it to this point and then did reapply gradient, you'll see a slightly different adjustment. It isn't quite as thin in the middle here. If I drag this up even further, like so, you'll see even less variation in the actual widths. So I can drag the start and end handles, but I can also drag points in between by clicking and dragging at any point along the graph. And now if I reapply the gradient, you'll see it is a non-linear adjustment. It goes from thin to thick to thin to thick again, as per the graph. I can get rid of these handles by literally clicking and dragging them off the graph area, like so. And I'm back to where I started. Alternatively, if I had altered this graph to a certain way, I can always go back to the default linear graph by opting for the panel's flyout menu and choosing default graph here. But notice that if I do that, it also changes the values. Those default settings actually reapply values as well. Let's go back and look at these default settings. You have the default graph plus these ones which are supplied with the package by default. And basically these letters are indicating the shape of the graph. So if I click on M, you'll see the letter M graph. Let's apply this gradient. And if I go and increase the maximum point size, let's apply it again. And you can see it goes from thin to thick to thin to thick to thin in a very elegant manner, replicating what this actual graph is showing. Now I can go for the W, which is the inverse of that, and see what happens by reapplying the gradient. And again, I can increase the value here. And this is the inverse of it, so thick to thin to thick to thin to thick. So I can opt for any of these graphs very quickly. But you can also create your own default. Say I wish to apply a certain graph which had a certain style. Let's go for something a bit different, like so. And I'm going to increase the end point size again. And after I apply this gradient, I think, yes, that's something I really want to keep for future design reference. I can go to the panel's flyout menu once more and go Save Graph. Now I'm going to call this one Demo and click on the OK button. And now, if I were to go to the flyout menu, I see Demo here. So say I had gone to another graph, applied a gradient like so, and wanted to come back to that demo one, all I do is click on the flyout menu again and opt for demo. And not only does it reapply the graph, but it also states the start and end values as I'd entered them. Now notice that if I change between the absolute and relative modes, they do retain their own graphs. I can actually go to the relative mode and apply that same demo graph style here, and it will apply these percentages in a relative manner as well. So rather than from 1 point to 10 points, it goes from 100% to 1000%. But I can gain access to that graph shape as well. Let's go back to the absolute mode. And the final thing we're going to look at here is the management of graphs. And via the flyout menu, I opt for manage graphs. And I can see all the graphs stated here, and I can click on individual ones. And if I hold down the shift key, I can select a larger range. Or I can use a tick option here to select or deselect all there. And I can import and export these graphs. This is a lovely thing. So if I had all the graphs selected like so, and I wish to export them to give them to somebody else to save, I simply do that, which opens a save dialog, and I can call it width gradient graphs, or whatever you wish to call it. And it has its own extension. And I click on the save button. And if I was another user, and I suddenly wanted to have these graphs come in, so for example, if I go back to manage graphs, I will actually delete the demo one for demonstration purposes. So I click on the demo, and I click on the little trash can down here, like so. I click on OK, and now I can go back to manage graphs, and if I'm the other user, I click on import, which opens the dialog, click on the graph I want, and click on open. Now in this case, I wish to append them so that I'm not overwriting anything I don't want, and I can see these graphs have now been added to my list, and any duplicates have actually been stated with an extra one next to it. So we now have the duplicates there. So you can manage your graphs as you like with this dialog. The one final thing you can do is also rename a graph. So if I click on this one here, and I will call it this peak alternative, like so. And if I go down to the menu now, I can see peak alternative.